African penguins were just recently increased to critically endangered.
The African penguin has met the criteria of probable extinction within the next 10 years if the current population decline continues. The number one driver is a lack of prey availability. The sardine and anchovy populations around the breeding colonies are heavily fished by commercial fisheries, and they are at odds with the conservation plans for the African penguin.
Our mission here is to regenerate the natural world through science, learning, and collaboration, and collaboration is a huge part of that.
Our team usually goes to South Africa about every 2 years, especially during their heavy chick season when they have a lot of juveniles and young chicks that need extra help. We mainly work with SANCCOB, the South African Foundation of the Conservation of Coastal Birds. SANCCOB will work with animal care professionals from all over the world. It's pretty much a team effort. The effects on African penguins are very real. For example, penguins that are coming in that are malnourished, or if their parents are currently molting, which means that the parents can't feed the chicks, you are getting birds into the center that need a lot of extra help because they might be dehydrated or underfed. It really shows how important the work that SANCCOB is doing and our involvement in the work too.
They can be quite long days. We prep an electrolyte that a lot of the birds will get because they want to make sure that they're starting the day out hydrated. And then it's prepping food for the next feed, a lot of cleaning, then medical checks, checking the feathers. They won't release birds unless their feathers are in good condition and they're waterproof. Want them to have the best success when they release them. And then they swim the birds. So if they're cleared, if they're healthy and they've been approved, they try to swim them as much as possible. Then you kind of start the process over, because then it's time to feed again, clean again, make sure that there's enough supplies prepped for the next day. You have this end goal in mind that you want these birds to be re-released and healthy.
The good news about this is that the data has shown that those chicks that are released back into the wild fare just as well as their wild-reared counterparts. So there is really hope in this method as a stopgap while we work on these bigger issues around the prey availability. Our managed care populations are even more critical than they have been at any point in the past. The Association of Zoos and Aquariums, SSP, or Species Survival Program, has about 1,100 African penguins in it currently, over about 52 institutions. And we actively manage the genetic viability of this population. They're really turning into an assurance population for African penguins. If at some point in the future we are not able to reverse the decline of the wild population, we will not lose the species in its entirety. And there may be some hope in the future to regenerate the wild spaces with eggs from our populations. AZA has a program called Saving Animals from Extinction, or SAFE. SAFE is initiated in country to help support the survival of African penguins in the wild. We are helping with tracking programs because at this point, every single bird counts.